Okay, I am back with Tarot of Reflections, and this is one of those weird decks that I just didn't know what to think about it. I bumped into it and I was like, I don't know if I am able to work with this deck because it's not really beautiful yet. It is beautiful. At least it's a strong deck and unique and special. And I noticed that it slowly sort of crawled into my mind and took over my thoughts and conquered my heart and I fell in love. This is one of those decks that isn't particularly elegant or magnificent or beautiful. It's the same with the Night Sun Tarot. It's not a deck that offers you a lot of eye candy right away. It's the same with the CBD Tarot, the Marseille from Yoav Ben Dov, I think. It slowly sort of takes over your ideas about how a tarot deck should look like, and then you can let go of everything else, I think. This is also a deck that you have to get used to, and the deck has to get used to you, I think, and it's not for everybody. It is on the darker side, if you read the little white book. Los Carabello, Francesco, Giampi, and an ugly sticker with an ISBN number on the back. And I am glad to have this, and I have been working with it for a couple of weeks now, so just getting used to the images and illustrations and the meanings, and not doing too much with it, but there is a very nice spread in it. Tarot of Reflections, and this is the first page. This is the little white book, and here's the spread. The language is English, Italiano, Espanol, Francais, and Deutsch. It's worth emphasizing the fact that the term speculation derives from the Latin word speculum, mirror, which originally meant the observation of celestial movements with the help of a mirror. Speculation then became synonymous with philosophical reflection and in general all thought directed towards clarifying something obscure. Obviously, the use of the tarot, and all the more so the tarot of reflection, is also a form of speculation in which the idea of it containing a progressive dulling of meanings is explicitly promoted. These little white books from Los Carabello always expand my knowledge about a normal Rider-Waite-Smith deck. They really have something to add to things that I already know, which is super, super cool. I can't think of a deck that doesn't do that. Storytelling and comic books are one of their specialties, and that really shows in the decks and the little white book. So this is The Fool. You know what I mean? It's a pink drape thing going on, and a orange skirt, and a yellow long sleeve, and scratches all over. This is what I mean. Is this ugly? Is this beautiful? It's a delightful design, I think. It's unique. There's nothing else like this. It's not a computer-generated, photoshopped thing. It's real illustrations. I love this deck. The Magician. And I will read the meaning of The Magician, so you have an idea about what I mean that did this about a little bit on the darker side. The Magician. Know what you want and why. Observe the possible scenarios. Keep silent about your objectives and then take a risk. Will and secrecy will be the best allies. That is so magician-ish. And yet it is not found in a Rider-Waite list of, you know, meanings, but beautiful ideas about the Magician always pop up. The best ideas about, you know, cards always pop up in the little white books that belong to Los Carabello decks. That's fantastic. Here you have the ugly pink and the green, and then I don't know. You know what I mean? The first thing that I thought when I saw this deck was, oh my god, this is, I don't know, weird, strange. Is it horrible? Is it ugly? I don't know. And then I ended up falling deeply in love with every card in this deck. There is not a card in this deck that I do not like, and that is super special. This is crazy. Just an example, again, to let you, to show you about, show you something about the meanings. The Hierophant. No one is born a master, and even those who teach can't know everything. Learning requires humility and patience. There are problems that only an expert can solve. That's, it takes a while to get used to the meanings that are the same in the, as in the Rider Waite Smith, and a little bit more and a little bit extra, and a reflection of the meanings. Lovers, this is one of my favorite cards. Look how strong this is, the Chariot. It's strong, it's solid. The wheels seem to float here on and in the reflection. So here you go. There you can see the reflection under the Chariot. But for me, this is amazing. The crown, the whole palette, the whole color scheme, the whole scratchy thing that goes on everywhere, the weirdness, the ugliness that brings ugly and ugly and ugly together, and when all ugly comes together, it turns into a beautiful piece of art, artwork, a pearl. This is, I think, one of those pearls before swines. People just don't notice it because it's too unique, it's too different, it's too strange. It is a little bit on the darker side. Look at this. I really, really like this deck. The Hangman. And like I said, I had to get used to this. Some decks are, you know, easy. A deck like this is an easy deck. You know, it's shiny, it's blingy, it's beautiful, it's yellowish, it's bright, it's happy, it's fun, it's, you know, easy to read, and you won't bump into any difficulties. You know, you can just pull it out of the box and start working with it immediately, and you won't have any troubles with the meanings, you know. Very nice. I like that one a lot. But to go a little bit deeper, this is perfect. When we go to the Tower, I will read you another one. Look at this. Look at this. There's the Spock thing going on. The Tower. Again, at first sight, not the most exciting tower, but I love the way this shows up in a reading, and I wanted to read this description. Every experience must rest on solid foundations if it is to last over time. Have strong inner foundations, demolish what is worn and eliminate the superfluous. How cool is that? It's not that you are being attacked or your world is bombarded with extremist things, but you know, you have to do the work on yourself. Maybe it's a left-hand path thing. I don't know. I don't know why I like this so much, but I do. And I showed you this card yesterday. I think. And this, the sun, the star, the moon and the sun are always disaster cards in a deck. Not always, but I see a lot of ugly stars and moons and suns. But, you know, and I think I think the star here should have be more prominent in the card, but it's still a beautiful. Look at this. I like the eyes. So shiny and yellow and everything about this deck is out of balance, and because it's out of balance, it's imbalance. It's harmony. It's strangeness, it's ugliness, it's weirdness, brings everything together in, it becomes one beautiful thing. Ace of Chalices. Look at these little water bubbles. If you can do this with a crayon or a pencil or a marker or something, then you are the coolest artist ever, you know? And because every meaning in the little white book is a reflection of what is in the card, it turns over to the more darker side, the more shadow side in us. The green hair and the chariot. I know, you know, this is moving away from, you know, everything is in here. There's still a lot of Rider Waite Smith in it, and yet it steps out of that circle of things that we already know. And then it adds to what we still have to become aware of, which is super cool. This is such a underestimated deck that really deserves a lot more recognition, because this is, look at this. This is always one of my favorite cards. You know, when a guy is full of himself and he sits himself in his, you know, whatever chamber. And it's bright and it's colorful and it's not a cuteness overload, something that I, you know, pisses me off. A lot. I don't want too much cuteness in a deck. This is lovely. The flat surface organization in the art, you know, is strong. The black here makes it, makes the pillar come out and the chalice on top, and then he has a little chalice crown on his head. Those flowers, and here is the end result on the design. This is one of the cards that I felt drawn to immediately. There are not a lot of reviews on this deck or flip throughs or something, but here everything is strong, and then it becomes, the lines become softer. Also going up, it becomes softer here. The center of attention needs to go here and then flow there. That makes the way the color leaves the image or illustration very soft and very beautiful. Here the focus is on the tree, and then you notice the man looking at it, the roots. Again, the way this, the focus is drawn towards the main character, and then the background becomes softer, is excellent. Here is the focus, here is a lot of focus, and then, you know, your eyes just go like this. Here the focus is more on the Ten of coins, and then it goes upwards towards the reflection. You know what I mean? It needs love, it needs time, it needs attention, it needs a little bit of care and tenderness. And I don't think this deck is for everybody, but it definitely is for me. This looks like something phallic, but also something organic. And this is like a little tail, like, you know, a man with a little tail. And when one show up in a deck drawn or created like this, I am so sold, you know, you have me. And when the moon is correct and the sun is beautiful and the star is attractive, then, you know. And what I also like, what I see a lot in decks, is that the wands are sort of soaked in red and the swords are sort of soaked in white and the coins are soaked in yellow, and that doesn't happen here. This is, wow, look at the reflection here. And the white sort of flows here into the fur. Strong eyes, swords. I think these are my favorite suit. It really screams metallic, iron, metal. You're sort of, you know, stuck here and chained. See, this is a totally, it is, you can see right away Smith in it, but it's totally different. And it goes into a depth of the right away Smith that doesn't show up in other cards. That's so amazing. Seven of Swords. This is so cool. This is a deck that I want to work with every day. Well, most of my decks I want to work with every day. But this is definitely in my top 10 decks. Absolutely, definitely. No doubt about it. So, let's go through them just for fun. Look at this. The throne, the way she is seated on it. This one, I can't. How? Look at the details. It's simple, it's elegant, it's not complicated at all, and yet it's full of meaning. And definitely do not throw the little white book away, because it holds all the information that you need or want. And the reflections are beautiful also. So beautiful death. Look at that little thing, housey there. And the sky here, the way it reflects is absolutely gorgeous. Here I like the whiteness in it and the soft pink. You know, it's a super temperance feel. And okay, the devil is in black, orange and red, but I still really like it a lot. There is no way back for me with this deck. It's not like I can forget about this one and here are people also holding a cup up in the air. little tattoo here, also in the reflection. I love the way this is, you know, this is nice. And then this brings everything into a flowing energy for a seven of cups. This is nice. Look at these teeth. There's a little face here in the right corner. Seriously, highly underrated deck, because I think they just, you know, the yellow shine here on the edges and the point of the sword. He looks a little bit tormented. This movement is amazing. It sort of rises out of the earth. A thought that lifts itself up. I mean, if you allow yourself to fall in love with your deck, with this deck, then you're screwed like I am. You know, again, the weird, it's in the center and it's not. It starts in the corner, it moves to the center, it then tries to move out of the card and then it comes back, and then you see the sword, which is the way, I don't know. I wish there were more tarot decks like this, because it's almost cruel how this deck takes over your life. There's a little cloud with promise and maybe a little bit of thunder. And this is the hair here. This is amazing. This is always a beautiful card. This one has to be beautiful in a deck. If it's not, then I'm not going to buy it. But very nice. So that's it for today. See you next time. Bye.